This video is for engineers challenged by voiding in die attach applications. It will cover causes and methods to avoid the void. Andy, with regard to voids in die attach, what causes them?
Well, first of all, soldering is a phase inversion process that the solid solder material melts, and then the fluid materials, which previously were present as the continuous phase, now become the discontinuous phase. They become potentially bubbles or voids within the reflowed solder itself, so that you have an entrapment of these kinds of holes within the solder matrix. And thermodynamics tells you that from the surface tension of solder, even the high lead solders have fairly high surface tensions. If you want to minimize the free energy of the system, you want to eliminate the void to eliminate the surface area that there is there and release the energy. So what that means is that there's always something that pins the void in place. And so I have this kind of phrase I use about pinning the void in a specific location. What is it that's keeping the void there? So if you look at a cross-section through a void under SEM, for example, you'll see that they're mostly gas or vapor. There may be a little bit of flux or some other foreign material in there, but it's mostly a gas of some kind that's in there. So that gives you a clue as to what's actually forming the void. The second question is, what's keeping that void in place?
So with that in mind, what are some of the methodologies or approaches towards mitigating voids die attach?
Well, you want to really eliminate whatever's pinning the void in place. So that means giving good solderability, so you can, for example, use a change in flux. We know that one of our fluxes gives a much better voiding performance than one other flux. You can use vacuum reflow. In fact, that's becoming a standard form of reflow for many IGBT modules, where those voids are very, very critical. You can change your reflow profile, the reflow atmosphere, particularly the oxygen level. The reflow atmosphere is very critical. And one thing that's becoming really concerning for thinned die, particularly very large thin die, is that the bending of the die itself can actually entrap air under the die, and that can cause problems with eliminating that, and really it's only vacuum that will remove the majority of that bubble.
Very good. Andy, where can we go to find out more information on how to avoid the void in die attach?
You can avoid the void by going to indium.com. We have a lot of information there, blogs, papers, and so on. And I recommend that as the first destination for anybody looking for information.
Andy, thank you very much.
Sure, my pleasure as always.